Yes, we need love. And I am a firm believer that. Good morning. God morning. Thank you for waking me up. Amen. So here I am, wake and bake with my favorite Robert Nesta Marley, aka Bob Marley. He's singing to me this morning. He's the first CD I have in my playlist. Actually, first CD I have in my playlist in my head, but it's my first, it's this first disc in the CD player. Blah, I said it. So, yes, there's no visual. I understand, because you have to listen. So I'm doing my wake and bake. So that means I opened up the Bible, and I go in there, and I'm at 1 Corinthians 13. Love. I may be able to speak the language of human beings and even of angels, but if I have no love, my speech, if I have no love, my speech is no more than a noisy gong or a clanging bell. I may have the gift of inspired preaching. I may have knowledge and understand all secrets. I may have all the faith needed to move the mountains. But if I have no love, I am nothing. I may give away everything I have and even give up my body to be burned. But if I have no love, this does me no good. Love is patient and kind. It is not jealous or conceited or proud. Love is not ill-mannered or selfish or irritable. Love does not keep a record of wrongs. Love is not happy with evil, but is happy with the truth. Love never gives up, and its faith, hope, and patience never fail. Love is eternal. There are inspired messages, but they are temporary. There are gifts of speaking in strange tongues, but they will cease. There is knowledge, but it will pass. For our gifts of knowledge and of inspired messages are only partial. But when what is perfect comes, then what is partial will disappear. When I was a child, my speech, feelings, and thinking were all those of a child. Now that I am an adult, I have no more use for childish ways. What we see now is like a dim image in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. What I know is only partial. Then it will be complete as God's knowledge of me. Meanwhile, these three remain: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. So what does that mean? God is love. So love to love. That's all I can say for now. But if you really want me to keep reading, holla. Because I got so much to read here. I got a whole book. And every time I read a page, it always comes out something different. It's always so great. Like, look at this. God's wisdom, Corinthians 1, chapter 2:6. God's wisdom. Yeah, I do proclaim a message of wisdom to those who are spiritually mature, but it not the wisdom that belongs to this world or to the powers that rule this world, powers that are losing their power. The wisdom I proclaim is God's secret wisdom, which is hidden from human beings, but which he had already chosen for our glory, even before the world was made. None of the rulers of this world knew this wisdom. If they had known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. However, as the scripture says, what no one ever saw or heard, what no one ever thought could happen, is the very thing God prepared for those who love him. But it was to us that God made known his secret by means of his spirit. The spirit searches everything, even the hidden depths of God's purposes. Wow! Deep! Holla back. I love you all. Bye.